Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Today I will explain about exposure triangle. So what is exposure triangle? So first let's talk about why this is important. So in this tutorial you can understand about the camera exposure and how you can manipulate it by using three component: ISO, F number and shutter speed of your camera. You can change the exposure and you can shoot from auto mode to manual mode from your DSLR, point and shoot and mirrorless camera. So if you in a portrait photography, if you in a wedding or fashion photography, or in a wildlife photography or sports photography, this exposure triangle can help you to create a great image. So why this is important? This is important because sometimes you can get a shadow or a very dark image. Sometimes you can get a very brighter image. If you are using in auto mode, then sometimes you can see your F number and shutter speed and ISO is changing automatically. So we don't want that, because these three things have some limitations and have some issues if we overuse these three things. So we need to know what is the limitation and how we can use this. So let's get started with this exposure triangle block. So this is my block. Here you can check the entire exposure triangle block and you can find more detailed information over here. Let me show you the triangle by which we will discuss about the exposure triangle. In this triangle you can see, if you increase your ISO, then your image get brighter. If you decrease your shutter speed, your image get brighter. Similarly, if you decrease your F number, your image get brighter. So why we are not using these three simultaneously and like to get the better result? No, I already told you these three have some limitations. So we will use these three things continuously, or you can say the proper manner to get out the proper exposure of your camera. So first let's talk about the ISO. Let's say we increase the ISO and shutter speed and F number should be same for every cases, then we will get the brighter image and a good exposed image. But somehow this increasing number of ISO can lead to a grainy image. So we want to avoid this thing. So that's why we are not using the higher number of ISO of all time. This ISO number, it's based on your camera. So if you using this ISO and all, then you have to know your camera body very well, and you have to know like in which ISO your camera body started to grain your photograph. So this thing you have to know. You can find out in the Google very easily. So this is all for ISO. So ISO basically a film sensitivity. So you have to know about the sensitivity number and all of your camera. So like for my case, 800 ISO is okay to shoot. So over that introduce some noise in my image, so be aware of that. So I will tell you later about this ISO actually. So this is the ISO thing, pretty much a simple straightforward thing. Then I will go for the F number. What is the F number? In the F number, you can see the lower number of lower F number will give you the proper and good exposed image with the condition of constant ISO and shutter speed. So to achieve this phenomena, you have to move your camera dial to the manual mode and fix your ISO and shutter speed and go ahead and change that F number. Many of the lenses you can find out like F number is start from 4, or some of the lenses start from 3.5. so that's why I put F4 for a lower F number, and F10 is a higher F number. This is pretty common for as a higher F number. My lens can reach to F22. You can see the shallow depth of field of this flower, background of this flower, and also this image is properly in light. And if you go to the last image, then you can find your that flower is not properly exposed, and the background it's deep. That means large depth of field. So larger depth number leads to the deep depth of field or larger depth of field. So making the entire image sharp. So you can end up with the higher number, higher f number, with a 2D kind of f image, but with the lower f number, you will end up with a 3D f image. So that is why we are using lower f number for portrait photography for good background blur and all. I will link one cheap and budget lens for this kind of activity for Canon user. So you can buy this lens, you can check this lens and buy this lens for further use for your portrait and any kind of good background bokeh. So this is it for f number actually. So this is pretty straightforward. If you decrease the f number, your exposure gone, like your image got brighter. Then go for the shutter speed. Okay, I just missed one thing. Like f number is a component of your lens, not your camera. So you can see some blade like structure of your lens where you can find the proper f number, proper blade. So that blade, it's depend that f number. If you go to the f4, then you can see your camera blade it's quite open. You can see like this way. And if you go to the f11, you can see your camera blade will closed. Just zoom in for you guys, so you can see this is kind of blade you can see in the camera. Okay, so go ahead with the shutter speed. So what is shutter speed? Shutter speed is the exact amount of time that camera record an image. So this shutter speed is pretty important for various kind of effect of your photography. So like I can see, if you want to freeze your movement, so shutter speed is pretty much important. I will provide a good tutorial on the shutter speed and how you can manipulate this thing in later point of time. So right now you can see one image that is pretty much shaky and you didn't find out the subject properly. So this is happened because I use 1/50th of a second. There is a lower shutter speed number. So usually we can see f60 is kind of a point where we are making, this is the, yes, this is the point, below this is the lower shutter speed. So that is why we are measuring, but that is not correct always. So this kind of freezing movement, we need to use like higher shutter speed, like 1/4000, or for lower number of shutter speed, we can end up with a shaky image. So if you are using your camera and you are out of option with ISO and F number, then you can use a lower shutter speed for enlight your image. So this is it for shutter speed. So this shutter speed is also a component of your camera body. So if I conclude it, so I can say like ISO and shutter speed is a component of your camera body and f number is a component of your lens. Lower f number and lower shutter speed means brighter image, but your condition should be fixed for every cases. You can modify only one component at a time. So for higher ISO we can end up with a grainy image. For lower number of shutter speed or lower shutter speed, you can end up with a shaky image. And for brighter lower f number, you can end up with a shallow depth of field image. But lower f number is pretty much expensive for a lens. So the budget segment lens, I can provide you the link down below. You can check that lens. If you want, you can buy this lens for Canon, and I'm pretty sure you can buy this lens for Sony and Nikon other camera as well. You need to find out the relevant option. So that's it guys, that's it for today. Please like, share and subscribe. Thanks.